Israel continuing its most intense airstrikes on Hezbollah military targets in southern Lebanon in nearly two decades, striking at what it says are hundreds of weapons caches and rocket positions inside of civilian homes. And now the U.S. is sending more military personnel to that region to augment the troops that are already there in light of escalating tensions. Now, the IDF warning thousands of Lebanese citizens to flee ahead of the strikes. The death toll right now, according to the Lebanese officials, stands at just under 500 people with more than 1,500 hurt. Israel and Iran-backed Hezbollah have been in near daily conflict since the October 7th Hamas terrorist attack on Israeli civilians and the ensuing Israel-Hamas war, with Hezbollah vowing to support Hamas terrorists by firing rockets, missiles, drones into northern Israel, prompting the evacuations of tens of thousands of Israelis there. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu saying that these latest airstrikes into Lebanon are part of a decisive move to push back on Hezbollah's near constant rocket attacks in order to allow Israelis to return to their homes. Now, the escalating conflict comes less than a week after hundreds of pagers that were used by Hezbollah militants simultaneously exploded across streets and supermarkets in Lebanon. This was part of a coordinated attack that was attributed to Israel, in which 37 people were killed. Most of them were Hezbollah members, but at least two were children and thousands were injured. This is according to Lebanon's health ministry. Well, the next day, walkie-talkies that were used by Hezbollah militants exploded in another seemingly simultaneous operation. And despite fears that the pager attack would lead to wider war, White House officials were said to be quietly impressed with the tactical feat of it all. Others, not so much. And it wasn't just the far left who have been almost reflexively, I should say, critical of Israel, because I want you to listen to former CIA Director Leon Panetta.
The ability to be able to place an explosive in technology that is very prevalent these days and turn it into a war of terror, really, a war of terror. This is something new.
Is it terrorism?
I don't think there's any question that it's a form of terrorism. This has gone right into the supply chain.
Yeah.
Right into the supply chain. And when you have terror going into the supply chain, it makes people ask the question, what the hell is next?
Now, last week, Senator Bernie Sanders accused Netanyahu of sabotaging plans for a ceasefire deal with that pager attack.
Every time a deal appears close, Netanyahu moves the goalposts, introducing new demands and torpedoing the deal. It is clear to me that Netanyahu is prolonging the war in order to cling to power and avoid prosecution at home for corruption.
And then we have Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez writing the pager explosions, quote, clearly and unequivocally violates international humanitarian law and undermines U.S. efforts to prevent a wider conflict. Congress needs a full accounting of the attack. Look. Is it fair to express concern about a widening war? Yes, of course. It's also fair to raise questions about the tactics on both sides. But why is it that, at least in the eyes of the far left, Israel can never win in the court of public opinion? There is no doubt that Lebanese civilians are caught in the crossfire. It is horrific. It is sad. It is unconscionable. But it's Hezbollah who's hiding among women and children as they send rocket attacks into Israel. And there is nothing, nothing that Israel can do in this war that will not be met with condemnation and criticism, whether it's saving its own hostages or launching a sophisticated, targeted assault on militants. It is only Israel who takes the blame. I want to talk about this right now with Cenk Uygur. He's the founder and host of The Young Turks. Thank you so much for coming on. Terrorism, really? The pagers, the walkie-talkies, they were held by Hezbollah operatives.
Yeah, no, I know. If Israel doesn't like them, they should be murdered. I got you. So let's talk about a couple of things here. First of all, Hezbollah, when they did that strike, they killed the 12 kids. That was definitely terrorism, right? You agree with that?
Well, I would say it's a it's an outcome of what happened, but it wasn't directly targeting civilians. If you ask me, if they were targeting civilian pagers or civilian walkie-talkies, by the way, just to let you know, if you look at the UN Charter, when they define what these weapons are, it would be civilian objects. If they were held by civilians, I would agree. I'd say that's a form of terrorism. But these are held by the militants. Of course, they're explosions. It's a tragedy that people are going to get caught up in it, but it's not terrorism. They're not targeting civilians.
No, Jesse, I asked you, the Hezbollah strike that killed the 12 kids.
Correct. Yes.
Was terrorism.
Correct. Yes.
That's terrorism. So today, Israel killed at least 35 kids. Is that terrorism?
You're equating the death numbers behind the purpose of the attacks.
So, okay, when Israel kills three times as many kids, not terrorism. Why? Accidental? Do they have an incompetent military?
Don't you think the motivation matters?
Because they're just Muslim.
Don't you think the motivation matters?
So, Jesse, let's talk about that. So, Hamas, terrible motivation. I'm not unclear about it. What Hamas and Hezbollah are doing is wrong. And you want me to call it terrorism? No problem. I call it terrorism. So, Hamas killed about 860 civilians in Israel on October 7th. Awful. So then Israel killed over 30,000 civilians at a minimum, including 25,000 women and children. So are you saying Israel made 25,000 or 30,000 mistakes? Or golly gee,
you want to question their tactics.
Those are all just accidents.
100%. You can question their tactics. You can criticize it. But I think that there is a difference.
Jesse.
But I think there's a difference. Otherwise, why are they warning Lebanese civilians to get out of those buildings?
One side is Israel, another side is Muslims. That's the difference.
No. Why are they warning Lebanese civilians to get out of the buildings before the airstrikes? Why are they doing that if the goal was to target civilians?
Jesse, imagine if a burglar, a murderer, an assassin was going to come to your house and goes, now look, I'm going to kill you, but I'm giving you a warning ahead of time. You've got about a couple of minutes left before I kill you and your entire family. Oh, I killed you all. You didn't get out of there early
enough.
Wouldn't
you say, though,
Jesse?
Israel keeps slaughtering,
but none of it ever counts. Jesse, for you,
but who started firing the rockets first? Did Israel attack Hezbollah in Lebanon first, or no?
You want to go
to that?
I mean,
after October 7th, what happened?
So there's two different issues here. So let me handle them one at a time. The reason why all the U.S. experts and every expert in the world is deeply concerned now is because Hezbollah's been firing rockets into Israel that are totally ineffectual, except that one that landed, for 11 months. It's terrible that they fire them, but they almost never cause any effect. So now Israel says, today is the day we decided, or recently, a couple of days ago, that we're going to obliterate Lebanon. So we're going to start exploding pagers and walkie-talkies and doing what the former CIA director and Secretary of Defense said is terrorism.
Israel's doing
terrorism now. Yeah, okay. And why is it doing now? Because this was the last possible moment that they could have a ceasefire. So since they don't, Netanyahu's saying, I'm not going for peace. I'm going for war.
I hear you. Unfortunately,
Jesse, do you understand that, though?
I hear your perspective.
You understand
unfortunately,
that?
We ran out of time. But what I'm going to tell you is
it's not a perspective.
You're talking about 60,000 to 80,000 people who are displaced. You're talking about people who were killed by the Hezbollah rockets. They keep on incoming. I'm not sure what Israel's supposed to do.
I would love to
continue this conversation with you. This is not great for 4 minutes. This is probably better for 40 minutes, but I hear you and I appreciate your perspective and I thank you for coming on.
Everybody believes that when Israel kills civilians, it's also terrorism. You guys on TV are the only ones who say, no, if you kill Muslims, it's not terrorism.
You're making this into a killing of religion aspect of it, when that's not what it is. I think the motivation behind it is
Israel
very important.
Israel has killed 40 times
Israel,
what Hamas
under the
has
UN
killed.
Charter, would
Israel
have a right to defend itself. Check again.
Thousands more than Hezbollah has. They're just not terrorists
because
you like
the
them
different,
more.
The numbers okay. games. And I think the motivation is the key here. But I hear you. I hear your point of view. Cenk Uygur, thank you so much.
They meant to not kill them when they killed them? It's absurd.
They did not mean to kill civilians. That's the difference. They didn't mean to kill civilians.
You serious, dog? You serious?
Did you call me Dan?
You, right?
First of all,
the
compliment.
World
appreciate
laughs
it.
At
I like
that
to
excuse.
Think similar. Look, Cenk, I hear you, but that's not what's going on here. Okay, I hear you, but thank you.
Oops, we accidentally killed 40,000 people. They're the bad guys, are
it's
they?
It's not an accident.
Or are you the bad
it
guys?
It is covering about the different tactics that are used.
And 5.5 million
all right,
people.
Cenk, Cenk,
Jesse, did they
Cenk,
also accidentally
Cenk,
occupy 5.5 million Cenk, people for 57 years? Israel is the oppressor.
You.
It is
All
Goliath.
Right. Cenk,
it's the one doing terrorism, according to our government officials now.
I'm sure there's people who agree with
no
you. I know there's people
Israel.
That agree with
no
me, too.
No money for
it's
Israel.
Still not, it's not going to be resolved in this conversation,
Almost
but I heard
no
your point
one does
again.
In the world.
Cenk, appreciate it. Thanks. Got
to
cut you.
Thanks for watching. Go to joinnn.com to find NewsNation on your screen. And don't forget to click the red subscribe button below to get more of NewsNation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.